On this lovely lockdown day, I've decided to try my hand at making some cinnamon scrolls. So this is my process and my trials and tribulations.
Okay, cool. So this is my bowl. For the dough, we need 3/4 cup of warm milk at 110 degrees Fahrenheit. I don't know what that is, but
okay, let's grab our ingredients.
Electric mixer.
We'll have to do this by hand. Oh my.
But that's me.
We don't have an electric mixer. Using some South Coast milk. So it says 1/4 cup of unsalted butter. But how much is that in grams? Because that's the only way that I can measure this butter. Oh, milk's done.
Oh no, oh no, oh no. My warm milk into here. My bowl.
How long can one person spend thoroughly confused by butter?
Honestly, I'm just guessing everything, so let's see if it works out. This is too much. Okay, so I've now melted my butter. Okay, you definitely can't see it without me spilling it. By separating the eggs. So, just one normal egg. And then one egg yolk. Oh, dang it. Now I need another bowl. 1/4 tablespoons. So 1 teaspoon. 1, 2, and a quarter.
But this is what it looks like.
So that's what the yeast looks like. And then it says to add the sugar, egg yolk, and melted butter. So the egg yolks going in, and the butter. It's like clumpy.
Definitely done something wrong at this stage.
Oh, I think I did it wrong. It's okay, I'll just keep mixing until we see how it goes.
So I added the flour anyway.
So the next step said just to mix it with a wooden spoon until it forms like a dough. And it looks like a dough at this stage. It's a bit crumbly. But I think it's at this stage that I was supposed to put it into like a dough hook. But I don't have a dough hook, so I'll have to knead this by hand. Oh heck. Oh goodness. I'm not sure how to do this. This is what it looks like right now.
So, the next step after kneading it for 8 to 10 minutes, which I definitely just did off camera, is to put it in a well-oiled bowl and leave it to rise for 1 hour to 1.5 hours with plastic wrap on top and then a warm towel.
Oh wow, it's really hot outside today. Okay, so I'm just gonna
pop it on this table. There we go. And I'll set the timer for 1.5 hours.
Okay. So there was success. My dough was in the sun for 2 hours and it rose. So now it's like a big ball. I was worried that it wouldn't rise because I checked on it after an hour and it was the same size, but it rose. So now we can move on to the next step. So the next step is to take out the dough and roll it into like a square or a rectangle. Ooh, wow, it's so cute. Wow, it looks so good.
My dough piece, it looks really good. It smells really nice as well.
Yes! Okay, so what's happened right now is that I've measured out the butter and I've got the sugar and the cinnamon and I've just melted the butter. So I'm gonna mix it all together and then spread it on here.
So I spend the rest of this time adding in all the ingredients, and then after I've mixed everything in, I realized that I actually like fucked up. So I was supposed to spread the butter on the dough first and then sprinkle everything else on top. And then I got to this paste and I was like, what the, how am I supposed to spread it? So then I ended up melting it down and re-spreading it.
I'm just gonna cut them up now. Just pretend that this never happened. Just turn them into fat scrolls. It's fucking a lot harder than I thought it would be. I thought it would be so easy just to make these scrolls, but it's not. It's hard. It's hard, hard, difficult, hard. Okay, so I'm gonna just roll up these scrollies.
Yeah, some of them have a lot of cinnamon and others have none. So we'll see how it goes. So this is what they're gonna look like. I'm in a tray.
This time it started off so well and then it just went downhill when I did this last section. Because I am dumb and do not read instructions. I think that's okay, but I'm gonna do this super fat roll. Shit, they're massive. They're gigantic. Okay, I'm just gonna cut them this way as well. So they're not super gigantic. They're a bit satisfying to make.
Oh, the meal is so much fatter than it.
Into the poor dog.
I probably should
bring
it
on. I did. I'm alive.
After all that fiasco, this is what they currently look like. I know they look a little bit janky, but just keep in mind that I don't know how to cook. So I just took my dog for a walk, and during that walk, I left the cinnamon scrolls in the sun so that they could rise. And then, so now I'm gonna pop them in the oven, and I'll show you what they look like after they're done.
What should I do? We don't have any icing sugar. Should I just use caster sugar, brown sugar, or... That's my only options. A problem solver. I just solve problems. I'm not a problem solver, look what just happened.
So I'm just gonna put this icing on top of these, and then they say to serve immediately, so I'm gonna try one.
It's quite fluffy, as I see it.
So it didn't really come out perfectly, but they taste delicious. 10 out of 10 would recommend that you make these at home.
So thanks for tuning in for my cinnamon scroll video. Lots of things went wrong, but hopefully next time I do another video, it won't be as bad.